the reaction in the pits there to what is a big concern about Iran?
Yeah, just talking to a couple of traders, and this, of course, comes, guys, just as, you know, oil was starting to drop and really, you know, somewhat precipitously drop and feel like, gee, we were in pretty good shape for lower oil prices. But here's the caution on this, and this is why I think, even though we've had a slight bump up in oil prices this morning, why there's not more of a strong reaction to this. Apparently, and this is from Phil Flynn giving me this information, the traces that were left in there that were found at the higher levels could just be essentially a technical glitch is what they're thinking, and that would mean that if it was just a technical glitch, it would be because at the start of enriching the levels are higher. It might not necessarily mean that they were heading towards some sort of weapon reuse for this. It may just be part of the enriching that they claim they're doing only for peaceful purposes, that is to say for power. So that may be what's keeping the lid on oil prices. But if there's any further indication from the IAEA, we could get another run in oil.
I want to hop in there to something that you said, though, because the report that's coming out of the agency, that it's Iran's explanation that this is a technical glitch. That's Iran's explanation. But you and I know both very well, we can't always trust what the Iranians are saying. And the agency says they're investigating these claims. I mean, obviously, in the pits, they've got to be very concerned about this next stage, a frightful stage for Iran, if indeed this is what they're doing.
As you can see, it has already stopped the precipitous fall of oil. And Phil was just saying, in fact, I see Phil. Hey, Phil.
Hey, guys.
Come here. Can you come here? Yeah. Oh, this is unconventional.
Yes,
hey, brother. Come on.
Hey, buddy, how are you?
Get in here with me.
Good, thank you. Oh, well, it's been a long time.
How big a deal do you think?
This could be huge, Jeff. I mean, this could derail the talks that we're having right now with Iran that was pushed back till June in Russia.
Mm-hmm.
It could make Israel basically... you lose their patience.
I was going to say, yeah, and
that's
lead
the
them to
concern.
An action.
Right. Exactly.
Right.
And when you're going into a three-day weekend in oil, with this overhang in the market, nobody's going to want to be short over the weekend.
How come we haven't seen more of a bump yet?
I think that the market is getting the news, and they don't really know how to take it yet. I do believe that...
I know. I thank you for running up here, by the way. I appreciate it.
This is the best workout I've had in a week. But anyway, essentially... I think as we get later in the day and this news makes around, people are going to not want to be short. That means that the floor for 90 is probably going to hold.
Because I talked to a few traders that didn't have the information. And this is, fairness, this has been percolating out here. And, you know, we hesitate to report when we hear, you know, this is like the world's biggest newsroom down here. And it's a rumor mill at times. But
really
now,
is.
Obviously,
it came
we're getting
out in bits and pieces.
You
know, there's one headline here. It wasn't confirmed. Another headline there. But now it's obviously being reported by a lot of sources. And this is huge, Jeff. It shows that Iran has been lying the whole time about their nuclear program. It's going to make Israel...
If this is true.
And Israel very impatient. And that raises the risk of a conflict, and that's going to raise the price of oil.
A breathless Phil Flynn, guys. First here on the Fox Business Network.
Dennis has a question. Guys, hold on. Jeff, stand by, because Dennis has a quick question.
Phil, before you run.
Yes.
By the way, Phil just ran up a huge flight of stairs to get to our location.
Phil, you might want to spend a little more time on the Stairmaster. But, guys, here's what I'm wondering, all right? Whoever really believed that Iran, with one of the biggest oil deposits in the entire world, was honestly interested in nuclear only for energy? We always knew they wanted a weapon. Why should traders flip out about this and send oil soaring?
Dennis asking, you know, we maybe thought we knew Iran was always in this for weaponry. Why, you know, why shouldn't oil be soaring?
Well, because they have been talking. And now, at least for the international community, the cat's out of the bag. You know, there could be plausible deniability from other countries, you know, supporters of Iran like Russia and China and some of the other countries that have had their back. But now it's going to be very difficult for Iran to suggest that they are not seeking higher grade uranium. And it would be very difficult for these supporters of this country to stand behind them in this issue. So that could be one of the issues that's creating a concern.
Okay. All right. We will be watching oil all day here.
Guys, thank you very much. Again, Phil, I know that I walked up those stairs. It's a tough climb. Thank you very much. And, of course, thanks to Jeff Locke for getting on the breaking news.